And now onto our dinosaur of the day, Nigersaurus, which was a request from Lanosaur via our Patreon and Discord. And speaking of rewards as patrons, if you're a patron, then you get to request a dinosaur. So thank you. Nigersaurus was a Rebbachisaurid sauropod that lived in the Cretaceous in what is now the Republic of Niger in the Elrhaz Formation. It was quadrupedal, and it had thick hind legs and a large tail. It was about 30 feet or 9 meters long with a short neck, only 13 vertebrae, and it weighed about 4 tons, which is similar to a modern elephant. Scientists have found a fossilized jawbone of a hatchling. Paul Sereno said that it was so small it could, quote, fit on top of a silver dollar, end quote.
That is tiny.
And cute. So it was lightly built with lots of air spaces in the skeleton. That means it was highly pneumatised.
Describing a Rebbachisaurid sauropod as lightly built. It's like, wow. I guess relatively, yeah.
Compared to other sauropods, yeah.
Yeah.
Nigersaurus, however, had a very solid tail, unlike most of the rest of the body. Its front legs were about two-thirds the length of the hind legs, and Nigersaurus was described as a Mesozoic cow. Seems to come up a lot. Anyway, Paul Sereno has described it as something between Darth Vader and a vacuum cleaner. He's also described it as a, quote, hammerhead shark with legs and a, quote, Mesozoic lawnmower, and this is because of its teeth. Nigersaurus had more than 500 active teeth in its mouth, maybe up to 1,000 teeth, and it replaced teeth about every 14 days, which is faster than most hadrosaurs. These 500 teeth were placed in 50 vertical columns, and the teeth were arranged in broad horizontal rows at the front of the snout, and the area where its teeth were are wider than the rest of its skull. So if you look at, we actually have a Nigersaurus toy, and it looks a little bit funny. Like, it's smiling really wide.
The hammerhead shark, I think, is a kind of a good analogy because it's so much wider in the front, and then it narrows behind it. But unlike a hammerhead shark, it's got teeth all the way across that. It's not just eyes sticking out at the ends.
Yeah.
It's basically, like you said, a lawnmower or something.
Yeah, Sereno also described it as a lawnmower. So all these things work. Nigersaurus' teeth were narrow and needle-shaped, and all the teeth were located far to the front of the mouth. It had a really broad jaw with a flat edge, and its snout was more broad than hadrosaurs. It had large nostrils, too, with the fleshy snout. Nigersaurus may have had a keratinous sheath around its jaws, and it had a proportionately short snout. Its jaws were wider than the skull, but the jaws were lightweight, and they had a few fenestra, the openings. Nigersaurus had weak jaw muscles, so it had a weak bite, possibly one of the weakest sauropod bites. Its jaw probably moved in up and down motions, and it would have gathered and sliced soft vegetation. It probably ate soft plants like immature ferns, horsetails, and angiosperms. Scientists think whatever plant it was widespread, since both Nigersaurus and the iguanodontian Lurdosaurus were the most common mega herbivores around in their time. Nigersaurus was probably a low browser, and it ate food with its head close to the ground. So it probably kept its head down, though there's debate about this. Sereno and others did a study in 2007, which found Nigersaurus kept its head rotated about 70 degrees downwards, and this is different compared to the usual horizontal position of other sauropods. In 2009, Mike Taylor, Matthew Weddle, and Darren Naish found that Nigersaurus could have eaten food with its head and neck at the 67-degree angle, but they did not think Nigersaurus always kept its head at that angle. They found that modern animals have a wide variation of semicircular canals, which are not reliable to determine a head posture. In 2013, Jesus Marugan-Loban and others found that Sereno and his team's methods were imprecise, and Nigersaurus probably kept its head horizontal like other sauropods. So, like I mentioned, a debate. Nigersaurus had many hollow bones, including in the neck vertebrae. Jeffrey Wilson said, quote, "The vertebrae are so paper thin that it is difficult to imagine them coping with the stresses of everyday use, but we know they did it, and they did it well," end quote. Because of its light spine, it would have been hard for Nigersaurus to lift its head much. Some scientists think that its vertebrae allowed it to have more range of motion, so it may have kept its head more horizontal most of the time. In 2017, Lucio Ibericu and others found that Rebbachisaurids had pneumatic skeletons to help decrease the amount of energy needed to move their bodies and decrease the amount of heat generated in doing so. So they tended to live in hot tropical and subtropical areas. Nigersaurus, as I mentioned, the skull was small and also light. There were large openings, fenestra, and thin bones. According to Sereno and his team, Nigersaurus' skull was designed as, quote, maximum strength with minimum material.
It's almost like cardboard or something. Doesn't look like it could support all that weight, but miraculously it does.
I guess so. Nigersaurus had large eyes, and it had a small-sized brain compared to its body. It had small olfactory bulbs, so even though it had a large fleshy snout, it didn't have a great sense of smell. The type species is Nigersaurus tachetae. The fossils were found in a 1965-72 expedition by Philippe Taquet. The fossils were described in 1976, but it actually wasn't named until 1999 after more fossils were found, and it was named in 1999 by Paul Sereno and others. Paul Sereno and his team found more fossils in 1997 and 2000, and they needed more fossils to describe Nigersaurus because the pneumaticity of the skeleton made the fossils much harder to preserve. So apparently some of the fossils in the skull were so thin you could see a strong beam of light through them.
Oh, that's cool. You don't even have to do sectioning in order to put it under a microscope. Just put the whole skull under there.
True. That's that minimum material, maximum strength.
Yeah.
So the fossils are now in the National Museum of Niger. The genus name for Nigersaurus means Niger reptile, and the species name is in honor of Philippe Taquet. Nigersaurus probably lived in floodplains. It was one of the most common dinosaurs found in its area, and it lived among large theropods and crocodilomorphs. Sereno said that Nigersaurus was easy prey, especially for Sarcosuchus, a crocodiliform. Nigersaurus also lived around the iguanodontian Lurduosaurus and other herbivores, including Oranosaurus and theropods like Suchomimus. Other animals in the area included pterosaurs, fish, and sharks. For those of you who listen to our Dinosaur of the Day segment and you like it, please consider becoming a patron. We take new Dinosaur of the Day requests from our patrons and offer a bunch of other perks as well. So check out our page at patreon.com/inodino or click the link on the left.